key player in an alleged immigration scam which left many Tongans out of pocket is to face charges of causing loss by deception. The arrest of Tongan woman Kolini Tatafu and the return of passports has been welcomed by the community, but police are still in possession of 27 Tongan passports which need to be collected. John Utanga has the story.
The case of Tongans duped into handing money over for the promise of immigration permits has been well documented, but it's taken some months to lead to an arrest.
We have informed the authority for the past few months and there was nothing done, but now yes, very pleased with the outcome.
The Tongan communities had a big part to play in the latest developments. Meetings held earlier this year led to cooperation between police, immigration authorities and community leaders.
I credit Nalison Dubo and Amelia Saafi, and there's another advisor named Tufuikama and myself, and there's a few other Tongan community leaders that we get together and start calling out for our community to come forward.
Police recovered 115 Tongan passports after the arrest. Most were returned, but they still have 27. They're urging their owners to come forward and collect them.
If anyone wants to come and collect their passport, we're not going to be sitting here trying to lock people up or deport them back to Tonga. We certainly are working together in partnership with immigration to make sure everyone's sorted out.
Meanwhile, police maintain the community needs to be careful about who they deal with when it comes to immigration matters.
The simple message is, if it looks too good to be true, generally it is. If someone's coming to you and offering, making you an offer that sounds too good to be true, make some inquiries and make sure that you're not handing over money and handing over things that you really can't afford to be doing.
Kolini Tatafu is the only one facing charges. She's been charged with 3 counts of causing loss by deception. She's expected to appear in court next month.